Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is a member of the Anointed Pace Sisters, one of the powerhouse gospel groups of our time.
Yes.
And she continues to use her gift to heal and inspire in her new book, Poisoned to Purpose, a gospel legend's journey. Please welcome Duranice Pace.
Yes.
Yay.
Yes.
Hello.
Miss Duranice Pace.
Yes.
Hello, Sister Circle.
Yes.
Glad to be here today.
Come on.
You
hallelujah.
Sing it out. I love it.
Okay. Well, you have, with that being, talk to us about the impact that your music has had on everyone.
Yes.
All of these years. And singing with your sisters, and what that's like.
Oh Lord, it was just truly been amazing. And then to bring healing.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it's all about.
Mm-hmm.
Seeing a person go from sad state to joyous state, or from saying I'm giving up now to I'm gonna hold on.
Yes.
You know, saying that, you know, I thought it was my darkest, but now I can see light.
Mm-hmm.
And in a song.
Yes.
This is, you know, this because he lived, I can face tomorrow. Because he lived, all of my doubts are gone. And people are like, oh my God.
Uh-huh.
You know, and this little thing I do with, it's a good day, it's a better day, brighter day, things are coming your way. Smile.
Yes.
The sun is shining, the rain is gone. Sit down, have a little tea, sip on
Come on, coffee
tea. With you and me. You know,
yes.
I'm gonna be all right. People,
hey.
They, you know, you walking up to them and you telling them this, and they looking at it, oh my God.
It's gonna be all right.
Yes. It's gonna be all right.
Yeah.
Yes. I love the simplicity of what you were just singing. You said, sit down and have a little tea.
Yes. Yes.
That's the simplest thing that you can do in a moment and be at peace.
Yeah,
it is so amazing. Now, I do want to talk about, there was some challenges with peace between you and your sisters.
Mm.
And what people saw in public may not have been the full story.
Mm.
How are you now? We saw you out on Ayanla, Fix My Life. How is your relationship now with your sisters?
Wonderful.
Oh, good.
Yes.
God really healed.
Yes.
You know, we did twice. We had to do it twice.
Mm-hmm. You need a little bit extra.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. They didn't. I held so much.
Yeah,
I kept. They didn't know.
Mm-hmm.
Why did you hold in so much? Why were you personally tormenting yourself with that?
Well, you know, coming up in me being 62. You got to realize where I was.
Yes.
You was told don't air your dirty laundry.
Mm-hmm.
And then you was also they treated you kind of negative. You said something about your negative things you experience,
mm-hmm.
especially when it happened with an uncle that has raped you, or and different ones in families molested.
Yes.
You don't say that.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
That you keep that. You know, it's gonna be all right. Take that to the Lord in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, when prayer's over, you know, you're like, why am I, I'm so sad.
Yeah,
you know,
still
why
the
am I vexed? Why am I frustrated?
Yes.
Why am I crying all the time?
Mm-hmm.
You know, why can't I be happy, truly? I can smile, you know, but after I get through singing on stage, after I get through, you know, making somebody else happen, then I'm somewhere in a corner like,
right.
Wow.
You've given so much,
you know,
there's nothing to feel.
Yeah.
You
right.
got.
Yeah.
Right.
Exactly.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So you've gone through that, and prayerfully you've overcome that.
Yes,
but also,
ma'am.
You've battled two bouts of thyroid cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And then it was rat poisoning.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, like so many different things have happened to you personally.
Yes.
How has song, you talked about it helping other people. How has song helped you?
Music is my medicine. Mm-hmm. I said it all the time,
mm-hmm.
because it really is. Because sometimes you can take it personal, and I did. I started taking the personal in the beginning. I like it. It's something on my forehead said hurt me, you know, mistreat me.
Mm-hmm. Also a painful divorce as well.
Yes. And so you after a while you kind of walk around kind of like on glass, or you know, you just like, what is it? You know, it seemed like I attract all the negative things. But I had to begin to realize that It's in me. Proverbs 18:21 said, death and life is in the power of my tongue. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. I had to realize that I had a deaf type of personality. Mm-hmm. I was talking deaf. Mm-hmm. Because deaf, negative things happen, you cannot talk negative. Yes. Because you was raped, you cannot re-rape yourself with your talking.
Ooh, ooh,
you know, sometimes you can hurt yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
After somebody else have hurt you.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
And sometimes mm-hmm. you have to just say to yourself, you know, the worst is happened. And it's over, and I'm moving forward.
Yes, and you definitely are.
Let's talk about your book really quickly. It's called Poisoned to a Purpose, A Gospel Legend's Journey. Can you tell us about the title of the book?
Well, because poison, it was rat poison that was given to me in a restaurant in Rochester, New York. Oh, they closed the restaurant down.
Oh, wow.
They asked me please not to announce it because they apologized. They did a big public thing in Rochester, the mayor and everybody. And I just cried like a baby because it was the cook. And I don't know why what I did to him, but he just wanted to put rat poison in my food.
Did you know him?
I didn't know him, but it was 12 of us every night, you know, eating at this restaurant. But they put it in mines.
Oh,
and so the third day, I began to wonder why I'm seeing black spots and things are going, everything. But Dr. Swartz told me everything was slowly dying.
Mm-hmm.
It killed off my gallbladder. It messed up my kidneys. It was killing my liver. Mm. Everything was going bad, you know. So you like I said, you have to know that, okay, God got something greater.
Yes.
And
yes.
I'm so glad I knew the word.
Right.
My father being a pastor, my mom, you know, I'm glad I knew the word because, you know, when the enemy comes in like a flood, and it was flooding in my life, God would lift up a standard.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Lord, that he did.
Thank you so much.
Yes, we appreciate you sharing your story with us. We truly do appreciate that. We appreciate that. Thank you so much. Listen, join her for her book signing at Life Enrichment Ministries this Saturday. In